Welcome to my humble little office. My name is R. Keith Andrews. I am a spiritual guide and paranormal adept. The journey continues today on October 27, 2021, at approximately 1:30 p.m. PST. The world around us is changing. Now, I bill myself as a spiritual guide for one reason. Okay, I'm not here to make choices for people. I simply return to this lifetime at this point to pass on one very simple message. And that is that working together, we can make this a better world for most people. Now, when I'm talking about working together, this means take all of the religions, put them all together, compare them, and you'll find, as I did, I looked through a lot of different religions. Okay, Christianity, Buddhism, Muslim, Hindu, Cree, the Church of Satan, Jehovah, Jewish, the list goes on, and I'm still looking into others. But here's what I found, is I found one set of laws, the karmic laws, and compare these to any laws that you follow, okay, any of them at all. Three karmic laws. Be true to yourself first. Do unto others as you desire them to do unto you. Energy out, energy in. Now, if in looking through your example, your guidelines, if you find one that doesn't fit in those three, absolutely, I would love for you to drop me a line in the comments below. If you want to make it more of a private comment that you don't desire the rest of the world to see, put it into my private contacts that you'll find listed underneath these videos. Now, I started off with religion because it really boils down to that being the backbone of a lot of things. Politics fall under the same category. If you take a look at the different political setups, people are all essentially the same. You've all come to this location, to where you are right now. No matter how you got here, you're all at exactly the same point. You're right here, right now. And this is the only time in existence that you can ever change anything. Okay. It's simply a case of, yes, you can talk about tomorrow and the things you'd like to see happen. You can talk about yesterday and the things that, that you've been through. But you can only change the here and now. Which is why I said, why I've talked about this idea of getting right with yourself first. Take a look at the world around you and compare what's going on in the world around, in your world. Take a look at what you're not content with. And then look at the things that you can identify which ones you've got some control over. By doing that, you'll find that your world starts working a lot better, and when that happens, you'll be better equipped to handle the people around you. Now, I'm finding more and more people questioning a lot of things. Okay, questioning the way the government is handling the world, the way health is being dealt with, the way that people's political systems are handled, the way that religion is, quite frankly, falling apart. And the reason I put it that way, is there are so many new religions, fractures of old ones, that are all of a sudden popping up in the last 15, 20 years. What happens is if you don't have, if a set of laws that you're promoting, number one, if the people that are putting the laws together are not following them, you're going to run into problems. The society will fracture. Okay. And that fractured society, if the new society doesn't have laws that apply to everybody, then it too will fracture. Net result, the world is coming apart. It's the puzzle that is the world that can be a beautiful place for all and for virtually everybody is coming apart. You know this because you can see the fracture lines happening. Not only are societies starting to come apart, but nature itself is retaliating. And again, I've talked about this before, that negative energy is causing some rather adverse weather conditions, adverse plant situations. Don't take my word for it. Do your own research. where it comes to the research on how negative energy can affect plants, I believe it was in Pennsylvania in, where are we, 2021? So it would have been in the mid-90s. There was a research, and there was a research program down there at one of the universities. I don't know which one. I seem to recall it being in Pennsylvania, in all fairness. But do your own research, where they proved beyond a shadow of a doubt that negative energy adversely affects the growth of plants and the productivity of them. It is already well known that that an office will run more smoothly if it is not cluttered. This is the principle of feng shui. Okay. And take a look at politics. And I'm just going to, because this is the only reference point I've got. But regarding the United States policies, okay, between the Republicans and the Democrats, from my understanding, if you look at their policies, if you look at them today and you go back and look at them again in the 1950s, you'll find that the policies that Democrats have today were the same ones that the Republicans had back in the 50s. And the ones the Republicans have today were the same ones that they had, that the Democrats had back in the 50s. Now, I surmise that Canadian politics with the Conservatives and Liberals probably had about the same setup. Okay, I don't know. I haven't looked into that one myself. Okay, what I do know is that the difference in people is negligible. I mean, you can certainly point out the differences, but all people, regardless of where you come from, regardless of how you got to where you are, every person, at least in the human race, every person has a parent, has parents, mother and father. Even if you were a test tube baby, as in vitro fertilization. Okay, even in a case like that, you may not know who the parents were. Doesn't matter. It takes, in human populations, it takes a male and female. Okay, so when you take a look at that, every person that is living today is a child. Okay, now you may take offense to that if you'd like. It's your choice. I personally look at it and go, wouldn't it be nice if many of the adults have gotten really caught up with the stresses of day-to-day life, could at least relax for a moment and look at the world with the wonder of a five-year-old? And I am referring to a five-year-old on a good day. There are days when a five-year-old is just, they're rough. Okay, but that said, okay, what I am noticing is more and more people, not only are they questioning what's going on, they're reaching out to other people and striving to make connections that bridge those gaps. Okay, and let's face it, when we take a look at even the whole thing around skin color. If you actually go in and do a DNA test, or if you get a DNA test, I doubt very much you'll find a single person that does not have mixed DNA at this point. As in, partially white, partially black, partially Chinese, you know, any number of mixes, and I'm not going to list them all off. But it is very likely, you know, I find it hard to believe that anybody is just one color. Okay, that's just from a rational standpoint, it doesn't add up. Okay, it is a good thing to question. See, the way it was put to me was, an argument is an exchange of ignorance. A discussion is an exchange of information. So do your own research. Okay, now part of what I keep doing when I propose these concepts is I'm looking, in all fairness, for a way to rectify the way that I'm looking at things so I can clarify my own mind. Seriously speaking, I'm on the same journey you're in. By the way, just because it kind of works out that way, this is a live recording, meaning I go back when I get done the recording, I double check to make sure I got the date right, and then I post it as is, with all the hiccups, all the twists, all the turns, doesn't matter. If you ever run into me in person, you'll find I do exactly the same thing. Because I just can't be bothered trying to figure out how to make everybody happy. You know, it was neat. I was told by somebody the other day, because I've mentioned the number of subscribers that I've got. And I was told, when you get into the, when you, as the number of subscribers rise, you'll get an increased number of people that are complaining about what you're doing. But in counterpoint to that, I also heard it put one day that even when the world is standing against you, if you know in your heart that what you're doing is right, it's, you owe it to yourself to be right, you know, to stand your ground. But don't stand your ground because you can. Okay. Years ago, I had a well-placed member. I was running my own radio program at the time. And I had a member of the Christian church, a well-placed member of the Christian church, on the radio with me at the same time as I had a well-placed member of the Church of Satan. Now, you'd think those two would be at complete odds. Now, first and foremost, I went into it. Now, I was raised Christian. I went into it expecting one thing, and I had my own erroneously preconceived ideas of what the Church of Satan was. But the gentleman from the Church of Satan, and I've double-checked this with other sources since, but he sent me a list of their guidelines. And I'll tell you, what I found in that was absolutely remarkable. I had my misconceptions, I did my own research, got information from multiple sources, and found something remarkable. The way I looked at the guidelines that they had, you know, the Ten Commandments and the 11 guidelines of the Church of Satan. Okay, the only functional difference that I found in between the two was with the Church of Satan, they say, if you're going to use magic, acknowledge it. But if you deny you use magic to attain your success in life, and you know, if you use magic and deny that you used it, then you will lose everything that you made. Okay. Now, I got that straight, that from him to start with. Then we went on with the radio show. And I kid you not, in less than an hour, I had these two people agreeing with each other that they were basically looking at the same world. Everybody on this planet looks at the world through unique eyes. So what we do is we find similarities, we find people of like mind that we can actually work with, that we can relate to, that we can gain support from when we're going through a rough time. Sometimes this is a church, sometimes a temple, a coven, a support group like AA, or like Alcoholics Anonymous, or Narcotics Anonymous, or there's a support group for, you know, PTSD, you know, childhood bullying, that sort of thing. There are support people all over the place. Okay. Now, with that in mind, it stands to reason that no individual is likely to be able to stand on their own without support. Even myself. Okay, like I'm pretty stubborn, I'm pretty reclusive, I stay away from people a lot of the time. But what I have discovered, and thankfully it's worked out really well, because with me doing these shows, and I try to do my best to do them one a day. Okay. By doing that, okay, I am getting, surprisingly to me, I'm getting a surprising amount of support and encouragement from people in private messages, in, you know, with positive comments that have information in them. Yes, I get the ones that go, oh, you're just a complete wingnut. Well, just to be clear, I spent decades trying to figure out if I was, because even my parents had let me believe I was. So I spent years talking to psychiatrists and psychologists, trying to figure out how my brain worked. All of the ones I went to came up with a very simple answer. Number one, now, do what you will with this. I'm not here to prove it to anybody. But every psychiatrist, every counselor I went to came up with one answer. There's nothing wrong with your mind, but you have a heck of a temper where it comes to dealing with what you consider stupid people. So, of course, they told me to stay away from stupid people, which is a challenge here. As the one guy actually put it, he goes, go home, have a nice life, but stay away from stupid people, and good luck with that. Okay. Then, just to tie it all together, my father on his deathbed turned around and told me that everything that I'd gone through in my life was absolutely, I remembered it absolutely correctly. Now, I'll tell you, there's nobody alive today that can back that up because, well, he died 5 years ago now. Okay, as a matter of fact, 5 years ago, in about, if I recall correctly, September 16th will be the 5th year anniversary of his passing. Okay, so do I look at the world differently? Absolutely. And when I'm talking about the tools that I offer and the philosophies I offer, understand, I came back to this world for one reason. Now, I've been here many times over the past centuries. I've got the memories and the corroborated memories, which is more important, of different lifetimes I've been here. Now, as I said this morning in one post, whether you believe in God, in a higher power, when we're talking about God, higher power, aliens, psychic phenomenon, you know, life elsewhere, the metaphysical world, you know, whenever we're talking about any of that, the people that believe it's possible, they believe it. There's no proof required. The ones that do not believe that these topics are possible or are real, there is usually very little in the way of proof that is possible. So I'm not here to prove anything. All I'm doing is going, this is the way I live life. These are the tools I use and the philosophies I live by. If you've tried, if you've attempted working with them before, you know, if you've done that already, then carry on. If you haven't and you're still struggling, absolutely give these new tools a shot. I'm not the only person out there with ideas. Okay, I'm simply the only one that has my ideas. And I'm the only one that I can say for absolute certainty that the tools I use and the philosophies I live by are the ones I personally have tested. Now, thankfully, this world is changing. I've noticed it most in the social media lately, where people are starting to point out the positive things. They're starting to ask questions. You know, they're starting to go, okay, we've been being led this all along. Another area where society has run into problems. When I was going to school, if you were going through class and you couldn't do the job, you couldn't do the work, never mind the work, if you could not come up with the answer, you failed the course. Okay. Somewhere along the line, things got sidetracked, and I'm seeing way too many people that are being given degrees, being given, you know, given their graduation certificates, being put in positions that they are clearly not capable of dealing with. Okay, I know of one case in particular where a young lass graduated from high school, got hired at a fast food restaurant. Okay. Now, she got hired, she got to the till, wonderful personality, really good with people. But when she worked the till, she punched in the order, and I watched this one with my very own eyes. She had a fresh graduation, okay, so she was doing really well according to the school system. But she punched the numbers into the cash register. It told her not only, including how much money the person gave her, okay. And she could not make change. She could not count out how much change it was. She couldn't even figure out what the answer was. The cash register actually told her how much money to give back. She graduated with an absolute inability to do math, to do simple, basic addition. Okay, now that's what the school systems are putting out. And here's the other little problem with that. I said a long time ago that IQs were dropping. Now, I honestly don't know how important IQs are, intelligence quotients are. But I do know about 10 years ago, from my understanding, the average IQ was between 100 and 130 points. The average IQ as of about 2 months ago was 85 to 115. Now, this unfortunately means that the massive majority of people, their IQs are dropping. Now, EQs, or emotional quotient, seems to even be further off kilter. Now, I don't know how they gauge that at all. What I do know is that people are finally starting to realize that we have to start working with each other. If we're going to turn this world back around and make it something that we can all function on, we have to work together. Okay, not just in the case of, and this is the funny part about it, really, in the case of a national emergency or of a localized emergency, you know, think of it this way. If it rains, it doesn't matter who you vote for. If you're outside, you're getting wet. Okay. If a fire breaks out, it doesn't matter whether or not you've got money in your bank account. If that fire gets to the right location, it's going to burn through your house. You know, these are just the normal things that are happening. Okay, nature doesn't discriminate depending on, you know, based on what gender you are, what your money is, what you look like, you know, who you vote for, who you worship. Nature doesn't worry about it. Okay, everybody gets treated the same way. It's time that we start treating people exactly the way we desire to be treated. Okay, that's how I live my life. I talk to people in the way I desire to be talked to. Okay, of course, I do have a bit of a short handle there. As in, you know, when I'm talking to somebody, if I get told flat out that my opinion is wrong, at that point, the conversation ends because there's no point in saying anything. But for your edification, your opinion cannot be wrong. The data you pull in can be. Okay, your assumptions based on said data can be skewed. But your opinion cannot be wrong. Now, I've talked about this idea of organizing your own, the energy in your own home. And this is why I am getting rid of the stuff that I don't require. That's also why I've got the down bottom shelf here. I'm now, where are we? Try and figure that out by looking. Those binders right there. Okay. If I recall correctly, though, as a matter of fact, I know I recall correctly, those are empty binders. But it puts them all in the same place so I know where they are. Okay. Because if you look on the shelf above it at the far end, which is way over there, I've got a bunch of little projects I'm working on there that I'm actually writing in. Not all of them on a daily basis by any stretch. My daily writing goes right here. Which reminds me, I've got a printer back behind this computer that I really should phone my computer support team for and get them to get the thing installed so it'll work. But we'll see what happens. In the meantime, okay, I'm moving everything that I need to. I'm clearing off shelves so I can get rid of it. That box there that you're looking at right on top, that'll only be there until I get off this video. Because that's got a bunch of paperwork in it that has to be filed. I went through another box that was three times that size and destroyed all the paperwork that was old. And when I'm talking old, I went through paperwork that was like receipts from 2006. Told you I was a pack rat. But get a look at your own life and really take a look at it and go, what are you content with? You know, it's easy to figure out, and it really is, to figure out what you're not content with. Those are the things you start reorganizing. Those are the things you start altering. Because when you alter the things, when you redirect the energy that's going to the things you're not content with in your life, all you're left with is what you are content with. Which is why I just sent off with the older Bakken Chronicles. I sent off the description and the information for the first of a number of pictures that are going to be entered into the Birth of the Wolf Pack. I left the room in it for before anyway, so now I've started working on those. Okay, plus I've got I think I've got 15 pictures between the so. Roughly about 15% of the pictures I need for the Races of the Worlds. Because these are two projects I'm working on. Now, the other big project, of course, is these videos. The idea is to point out, to show people not only that working together we can make this a better world, but to guide you through the process in how to go about making it happen. But you have to start with yourself. Okay, you're the only person in existence that can be successful for you. You're it. Lots of people can give you ideas on how to go about it. They can tell you what they think you should do. But when you're looking at accomplishing something solid, talk to somebody that has successfully accomplished it. Now, in my case, I've got all kinds of things I've been through. Now, of course, obviously I've got more experience than somebody that's only been here for 10 years. Okay, I'm 58. So obviously I've been through more. And as I've told people before, the two most wasted commodities in existence, quite frankly, is the wisdom of the seniors and then the enthusiasm of the youngsters. Okay. The seniors, by their simple definition, have been here longer. They've been through things that you may be going through. Talking to them, to the ones that have successfully orchestrated their life through these challenges, is a good way to get a handle on it. Talking to the munchkins, as in the children, those are the ones that just haven't been hurt so bad, usually, where they become extremely cynical. And rest assured, I've got my cynical side, in case you hadn't noticed. Okay, so what I've decided has to happen for me to really get my head on straight, I'm doing a lot of changing to me. I'm opening doors to kind of to take a look at other things. Okay. And ideally, and this is a really weird way for me to look at it, because the last place I wanted to be was on a pedestal or, standing in front of a whole pile of people. Ironically, that's where I seem to be heading. Now, I really don't have, there's nothing different about me, other than I now know exactly what I'm aiming for. Okay, people on the whole have their own way of looking at the world. Okay, and it is very much a necessity that we work together to make this a better world for most people. Okay, and from my end, it really boils down to an issue of getting that message out that regardless of how you got to where you are, it is possible working together, working with other people, that we can make things change. Okay, but that change is up to you. Okay, now with that in mind, I'm going to bring this to a close. I will be back again tomorrow. Okay, until then, take care of yourselves and each other, and for pity's sakes, stay positive.